Marie Kondo has become a household name because of her Netflix show and her books about tidying. In this video, she talks about her inspiration and techniques for clearing up space in 8 parts.
I was born and raised in Japan, and I was brought up in the Koto Ward, a small ward in Tokyo. Since I was a little kid, I loved organizing. When I was 5, I started reading magazines that had to do with homes and organizing. My mom was a homemaker, and she looked so happy doing things around the house. My mom loved doing chores, but she wasn't necessarily perfect at it. My home wasn't that disorganized, but it wasn't super neat either. Regarding Shintoism, it's more of a very natural part of my life. The reason why I worked there was there was an opening and they were hiring an attendant maiden. It was a very casual decision. And when I was 12 years old, even at that age, when I went to a shrine, I felt very peaceful and put together inside. The work is very simple. There are people who come to pray and we sell them lucky charms, and we also clean the area as well. It was originally just a hobby. I loved organizing my friends' houses, but then word spread and people started saying, hey, if Marie goes over to your house will become super organized. That's when people that I didn't know started reaching out to me and saying they'll pay for the service. I loved studying and experimenting with organizing since a young age. At the time, for me, organizing meant throwing things away, but even when I threw things away, I didn't feel like I was organized. This was a very negative way of looking at things. I was throwing away so many things that I called myself a discarding machine. I was always looking for reasons to throw things away, and this became extremely stressful. I've actually passed out from organizing too much. When I woke up, I was thinking, what's important in organizing is not focusing on discarding, but really focusing on what to keep. It's really how to make your room into a space that sparks joy, full of things that spark joy for you. Really the first time that I realized the spark joy concept. Showing appreciation for things, becoming a consultant at 19, this was something that I already did. You can either say it out loud or in your head. What's important is to really feel that appreciation. When you're discarding something or when you're throwing something away, it's pretty common to feel guilt, but it's really important to feel that guilt. And by saying thank you, it becomes easy to throw away. You need to face each and every item. When you hold it in your hand, do you feel the joy? Does it give you that warm, fuzzy feeling? And does that make you want to keep it with you? If all those feelings are positive, then I suggest you keep it. And that spark joy feeling is a muscle that you train by going through the tidying process. Consciously train that muscle, and then you're able to know what you need now at the moment and what you need long term. Of course, I think it's lovely to have short term spark joy items as well. It's not about long term or short term.